Welcome to DPV Technology. In this video, we will learn how to connect this two-channel solid-state relay with any microcontroller. For the demonstration purpose, we will use this Arduino microcontroller and we will control two AC bulbs with the help of this two-channel relay module. So let's get started. You can buy all types of electronic components, modules, sensors at best price from www.dpvtechnology.com. Here is our two-channel 5-volt relay module. This is the input side of the module, and this is the output side of the module. This module has four input ports at the input side, marked as DC plus, DC minus, CH1, CH2. DC plus and DC minus pins are used to supply power to this module. We can directly supply power from the Arduino Uno board for this two-channel relay module. But in most of the cases, this voltage is not sufficient for this relay module due to low output current of the Arduino 5-volt pin. Therefore, in this video, we will use a 9-volt battery to supply power to this module. CH1 means channel 1 and CH2 means channel 2. These pins are used to send signal to the relay module from the Arduino microcontroller. Now, at the output side, we can see there are two output ports. Each port has two pins. The output ports are marked as switch 1 and switch 2. We have to connect our AC load to these output ports. When we send a high signal from the Arduino board to channel 1 of the relay module, the switch 1 will be turned on. Similarly, when we send a high signal to channel 2 pin of the relay module from the Arduino board, the switch 2 will be turned on. If your relay module is of low-level triggering type, then you have to send a low signal to turn on the relay module. In our case, this is a high-level triggering type relay module. So we have to send a high signal to switch on the relay module. Before going to circuit connections, let's move to the circuit diagram. Here is the circuit diagram. This is the input side. We have to connect the DC plus pin to positive terminal of our 9-volt battery. Then DC minus pin should be connected to ground terminal of our battery. Also, we have to connect the DC minus pin to the ground terminal of our Arduino board. Then we have connected the channel 1 pin of the relay module to pin number 8 of the Arduino. The channel 2 of the relay module is connected to pin number 9 of the Arduino. You can connect the channel 1 and channel 2 of the relay module to any digital pin of the Arduino according to your program. Then at the output side, we have connected two AC LED bulbs. One terminal of the relay module is directly connected to AC and another terminal of the relay module is connected to AC through the LED bulb. Similarly, we have to connect the second bulb to the second port. Now here is our input side connections. This is the DC plus pin that is connected to positive terminal of our 9-volt battery. DC minus pin is connected to negative terminal of our 9-volt battery. Channel 1 and channel 2 pin is connected to pin number 8 and 9 of the Arduino respectively. Make sure to use this common ground in between ground pin of Arduino and ground pin of the battery. Now at the output side, we can see this terminal is directly connected to AC and another terminal is connected to AC through this bulb holder. Similarly for the second bulb also. Now connect your Arduino board to your PC through USB cable. After that, connect the plugs to your AC supply. Be careful because AC supply will be there at the output side after connecting to AC. Now open your Arduino IDE software and copy and paste this code. The link of this code is given in the description of this video. This code is very simple. At the beginning, we have connected the relay modules pin number 8 and pin number 9. Then we have kept this pin mode as output for the relay module. Then we are sending a high signal to both the channels to turn on the switch 1 and switch 2. So both the bulbs will be turned on. Both bulbs will be turned on for 2 seconds because we have introduced 2 seconds delay here. Then we are sending a low signal to both the channels to turn off the switch 1 and switch 2. And it will be off for 2 seconds. Since these codes are written inside the loop section, so bulbs will be turned on and off after 2 seconds interval. Now go to Tools, select your proper board and proper port, and then upload the code. Here we can see done uploading. Now here we can see bulbs are being turned on and off according to the program. You can buy all types of electronic components, modules, board, sensors from the official website dpvtechnology.com at best price. Thanks for watching.